Good day, everybody. Welcome to our daily broadcast, Foreclosure Hump Day Intel. Going to talk about those seven listings that are foreclosures, where you can find those. That's only in the Santa Clarita Valley. If you're in the other Southern California cities, scvnest.com, scvnest.com. You'll be able to search for bank-owned. Just punch that into the search box there at scvnest.com. Start with bank-owned, and then you'll see bank-owned foreclosures pop up. Also, what we did is we went ahead and included short sales in the mix because those are also distressed properties, and some can be fantastic deals. So we threw those in there. Hump Day broadcast. Welcome to Wednesday. We do this every single Wednesday. We had some interesting conversation yesterday with a client with regard to a listing. We're going to talk about sellers overpricing their listings. Well, I would venture to say agents convincing sellers their listings are worth more than they actually are, and the dangers of that. Today on the market for sale, seven foreclosure listings in active status in Santa Clarita Valley. Here in Southern California, about 225. Those are actually bank-owned properties. You can see all of those at scvnest.com. Now, there's three statuses with regard to foreclosures. You have your active status. You can find out more about that by going to Paris911.com, Paris911.com, into the Mac box at the top part of the screen, punch in the word active. So again, we'll give you a little something to do. That's going to show you more about the active status. Backup, B-A-C-K-U-P, backup. That we have properties in that particular status as well. Again, Mac box capable word. Backup status is going to mean the intent for the homeowner or the owner, if it's a bank or some kind of financial entity, is that they want that property to continue to be shown just in case that original offer, the offer they've actually signed off, executed and signed off of, in escrow with, in case that one teeters and falls out. It's good to know that that's where the minds are of the sellers. However, a lot of times, here's the rub, a lot of times that status happens to be used, unfortunately, because it still puts a property out there in an advertising mode, marketing mode, still showing the property is being active. If you are looking online, you need to know the difference, and also you need a professional. Reach out to us. We'll be happy to help. Now, some of our online resources for foreclosures, where this particular show is going to be hosted, one of them is foreclosures.paris911.com, foreclosures.paris911.com. We do have systems in place to allow you to search for distressed properties. And you might ask, well, Connor, are distressed properties really a great deal? Depends on the market. Also depends on ownership of that property. Is it by a financial entity that knows their way around the real estate block, or is it by a hedge fund or another investment group that really just wants to get rid of it and has a different type of strategy? It's going to depend. A lot of the foreclosures are based on a 90-day in the future estimate of value. That's something people forget. In a declining market, if you remember, if we were declining 3 to 5% per month, that would be factored in at the date that property was made live in the multiple listing service at that particular price 3 months in the future. You could see as much as a 12 to 15 to 20% discount on that property in comparison with today's prices. So, of course, a lot of people wrote those offers and wanted to get in on the absolute great deal that this property was. If you have an increasing real estate market as we see today, then what that's going to do, it's going to have the opposite effect. So instead of being available at a discount, this property is going to be more expensive. If we are inclining now 1 to 3% per month, it could be 3 to 9% more expensive than today's fair market value. And that's where people would start because they're a little panicked. Now, in the local markets here in Southern California, Santa Clarita, we see prices consistently flat, and they have been throughout the holidays. What's going to end up happening, we're starting to see it slowly occur, just like it does in every market, during the spring cycle, into first quarter, beginning of second of every year, depending on whether the market's distressed or healthy, and the needle's pointing back to healthy for our market. We're going to start seeing a lot more movement out there with regard to people searching for homes. That, in turn, is going to be the kickoff mechanism for sellers to start listing their real estate for sale, because now they want to move. They want to get out. They want to downsize. They want to move up. Whatever it may be, they're going to start listing that property for sale, which brings me to today's show topic, the dangers of overpricing listings. Example, very simple. Showing some great clients last night, went out, started viewing real estate. First house we happened to stop at was listed by one of the locals out here. Yet, I was inside, they were inside, and we were looking at each other somewhat perplexed because we have been looking at real estate for a while. And if you work with us, what'll end up happening is you'll start to be a really good observer. And because I've already pulled multiple values for you, showed you what other properties have sold for in these particular neighborhoods you like, you'll start to be able to make that call. This property, ladies and gentlemen, was in excess of $65,000 overpriced from the last sold comp. $65,000. And this is, you know, an agent that's very well known. The question is how do we battle that? We're going to fire off an offer anyway, $65,000 less. Here's the problem. He's already potentially sold his seller on that price. My buyer isn't going to have a chance when it comes to having the offer accepted at $65,000 less. In fact, for the most part, if he hasn't had this conversation with his seller, the seller is going to be offended that we would write so low. I'm going to send him comps. I'm going to show him that 460 was the highest a home had sold for within the last 6 months, and it was actually larger than the property we looked at. I'm going to show him that. But will he transmit that to the seller? More than likely, no. He probably will not. He's going to go ahead and take it upon himself to say, are you crazy? What have you been smoking? What's going on with that? That's a big danger. Plus, what if you have a buyer working with an agent that is not willing to step forward and write an offer anyway, just to make sure that the seller won't accept? In some of those circumstances, you might get an acceptance, albeit it's going to be incredibly rare. But what if the buyer says, you know, we're just too far on this, I don't want to write the offer? That's going to be 80 to 90% of the time. On the other side of that, you have their agent, the buyer's agent. What if they don't believe it's worth it to write the offer? That, again, is 90 to 95% of the time. You have that occurring, where the agent representing the buyer is going to see this particular agent maybe habitually overprices real estate, goes to sellers and tells them, oh yeah, I can get this all day long for your listing. Oh, you're competing with Connor McIver and these other people to list your house, or I am? You know what? I think I can get more than what I just told you. So let's go up even higher. I'm willing to try it. Unfortunately, the trying thing could be detriment to a real estate seller. You have to make sure what your property is worth. And then if your strategy is going to be to go $65,000 over market, understand exactly how many people you're cutting out of that equation that in fact won't even see your home for sale because you priced them out. And that's going to be a big chunk of people. Strategy is important. Overpricing listings is very dangerous. My recommendation, get opinions from more than one agent. In addition to that, if they're talking about advertising and marketing, if they're talking about that being their claim to fame, that's not bad. Do yourself a favor. Do a search for them online. See what they're about. Match that up with who you're interviewing. If you're reading stuff online, it's not making sense, or if you're not finding anything, that they're explaining to you. If they don't have sites or systems in place where they explain the market, they don't have to do a daily radio show like we do. That's not the point. They don't have to do all the YouTube videos that we do either. IntelHousingRadio.com, HousingRadio.com is where we have all the past radio shows. And with regard to YouTube videos, SCVTube.com, you'll be able to see all those. But they don't have to have all that in place. Just make sure that they're not overselling you. And when you're selling your house, you really do need to sit down and look at those numbers. It's easy to take somebody's word for it, but it's so important to sit down and actually look at what they're showing you. And here's what you look for. You want to make sure that they're comparing the same types of homes with your home. If they're trying to compare million-dollar homes behind a gate with your home that's not behind a gate, not on the golf course, and tapping out at $750,000, but they're trying to convince you that the appraiser is going to take into account a home that is behind a gate, on the golf course, with a swimming pool, and compare it with yours, be careful, because that's not actually the case. If they need to use that property to be of assistance because there's not enough closed inventory in the past 6 months, then maybe you should see all the closed inventory. And if you have a question about that, all you have to do is fire me off an email, and I'll send you the closed inventory in your particular area or tract or within half a mile to a mile radius that's closed in the last 180 days that matches your home. It's called comps, folks. Happy to do it. Paris911.com. You'll see up at the top a way to contact us. Paris like the city. A little bit of background in that. So anyway, overpricing your listing, dangerous. For buyers and sellers, dangerous. Don't do it. Make sure that you speak with a professional and make sure you see those comps. If they're telling you they can get $65,000 to $75,000 over the last sold comp today, they're lying to you. Be careful with that. Moving back to real estate resources, of course, housingradio.com. If you folks are on Twitter, please check us out at Twitter. No, that's Twitter. Twitter.com/housingradio or at Housing Radio. Facebook followers, facebook.com/housingradio. Please check that out. Today's been our hump day broadcast, talking about real estate of a distressed type and also the dangers of overpricing your listing. Tomorrow, Truth in Lending broadcast. When was the last time your lender screamed at you? Got to be careful. Let's talk a little bit about paperwork and timelines tomorrow with regard to Truth in Lending, because it does irritate a lot of people when the lender's asking for the same document. What's that all about? We'll talk about that tomorrow. Plus local inventory, 7-day forecast, as far as past 7 days, talking about real estate, what's going on. By the way, you want to see those 80 new listings that have hit the market this last 7 days. If they're still available, go to scvnest.com, scvnest.com. You'll be able to see all of those. Hook up with us on Facebook and Twitter, please. I would be honored. I am Connor McIver. Have a great day. We will talk to you tomorrow. And please share the show for people you know. Connor McIver over and out.